Others have always kept her down. On Monday, a lonely piece of ice in a very chilly arena. There are no crowds at the compulsory figures, no music to skate to. It becomes a psychological battle on ice. It's a seven-hour day, and it starts even before your eyes have cleared from the night's sleep. Precise tracings on the ice, and they count 30% of the total score. Elaine looked nervous, impatient for skating, as well she should, given the history of her performance in compulsories. The coaches watched the competition unfold. You know, 1 year ago, the dream of a second gold medal vanished as the pain in an injured right ankle knocked her out of the compulsories.
I haven't cried yet today. Get it out. Last night, I was to the point where I couldn't cry anymore. So, I guess there's just a little left.
In Helsinki, Elaine never made it to the short program. The 16-year-old veteran thought her career had ended. She'd been in a cast for weeks. After months off the ice, she tried to fight back. But it was slow and painful.
I think you learn a lesson from everything. And I think losing the nationals and not being able to compete in the worlds really made me want to get up and go again and be better than ever. And I really feel that you really have to hit bottom before you can bring yourself back up.
Elaine had gained a full 20 pounds, and the athlete who had made the triple jump child's play had to settle for more basic routines. Super skates in October. But here in Ottawa, after her sixth-place Olympic finish, a trimmed-down, healthy Elaine Zayak was back in the World Championships. But in the compulsory figures, she knew it would take a superhuman effort for her to keep up with the powerful Soviet and East German skaters. You skate three separate figures. And then you wait. The same judges watching the compulsories would judge Elaine in her competition in the short and long programs as well. Elaine is no pressure before, you know. But as she competed here in Ottawa, she had to feel the burden of carrying the flag alone.
The rest of it is good, except you screwed up how you get.
But now she moves into her specialty, the free skating program.
5.6 second.
Rosalind Sumner's turned professional Tiffany Chin is injured, and now it is the lone American, Elaine Zayak, as she looks for a medal at these World Championships.
Combination. I think that was a significant moment. Now let's see what happens here. Coming up her next difficult jump, double axel. Double toe ollie, double like this. She's got a chance.
She was on her way home from Helsinki at the World Championships with an ankle injury. Couldn't compete.
Isn't it interesting that it was her athletic ability, her strong technical ability, those triple jumps that brought her to the forefront in the first place, and now in her final, perhaps her final, world championships, it's going to be the one thing that could give her a chance to get in the medals.
And the one thing she's been criticized for as well.
That's right.
Another.
Smile. She is excited. The hard part's over. 1 minute left.
Away from the end of her program.
Final double axel. Combination into a double toe loop. Butterfly and a fast stretch spin. I think she knows she's done something.
Thank you to the crowd here in Ottawa. The first 3 minutes was hard work. That last minute was for everyone in this stadium.
You know, I've got to tell you, that's got to be the performance of her life. What a way to leave amateur figure skating. What a moment for Elaine Zayak.
This lady who began skating at the age of 3 and a half.
And here's her opening combination. Look at that triple toe loop. She falls out a little bit, but holds it long enough, I believe, for it to be counted. And right into a double toe loop. Now, let's take a look at a later triple toe loop, which she lands perfectly, and look at the excitement in her face when it happens. Watch her. She's going up in the air. She's very straight. Nice rotation. Look at that face. That's great.
Now, Zayak, with Peter Burrows waiting for the scores for technical merit. She has to score well here. Remember, Katarina Witt and Ivanova are ahead of her at this point. Kondrashova, the other Soviet. So technical merit scores are very important, and they are very good.
They certainly are. And, you know, those scores put her ahead of Ivanova in the long program, and that may be just enough. I don't know, but it may be just enough for her to move right into the medal round.
What's amazing is how strong her free skating program is. She's able to come back and fight back from the poor compulsory results.
That's right. She's a great competitor.
Artistic impression. This could well tell the story. Now, the low of 5-6, but the rest of them are better than the Soviet girls. The 5-6 was from the Swiss judge, and Misha's now making his way down to have a word with Elaine. The question is now, are those scores enough to give her the bronze medal? Let's go down to Misha.
How was it?
Oh, it was great!
That was absolutely a stupendous performance. Are you happy about it?
I'm so happy. All I wanted to do tonight was go out and skate my heart out, because everybody was saying, you gotta get a medal, you gotta get a medal, or, you know, you gotta do it for the United States, and that's what I wanted to do for. I wanted to do for everybody. That made me feel good. all the time, and I just wanted to thank them, too.
And you had to do it for yourself.
Oh, of course.
For the
I
last...
had to please myself first.
That was terrific. What is this? Does this mean that this is the last performance? This is the one that's going to go down in history for you?
I hope everything goes down in history. I think that I haven't made up my mind, and everybody keeps asking me that question. I think I want to end my career on a good note, and I think this would be the best time to do it, because that's what I wanted to do, was go out and show everybody I could do it again.